Any concept in computing is inevitably an abstraction of a more complicated concept underneath. If you think about using a computer, you're clicking around on the screen, and the things that you're clicking on the screen are widgets. So if we look at a title bar like this, then there's three buttons up here. So those are widgets on the computer screen. For most people, I think that's where their understanding of computing begins and ends, right? But obviously, when I push that button, that prompts the computer to go away and do something. How does it turn that input into some electronic stimuli? If every time we wanted to describe how the click button on the screen works, I had to talk to you in terms of electrons bouncing around inside a wire and explain the quantum mechanics of a transistor, then it would take an enormous amount of time. And so, instead of talking about quantum mechanics in a transistor, I abstract that idea. And I say, look, a transistor is just a switch, and that switch can be open or closed. And the electrons traveling down a wire, they're either there or they're not there, which is a one or a zero. And in Numberphile, we talked about ones and zeros a lot, so we won't go back into that. But it's just numbers traveling down a wire. Most computers are 32-bit and 64-bit these days. We have a series of wires, parallel wires, which run together, and we give those a fancy name called a bus. And so it's ones and zeros traveling down a bus, and they represent numbers. And then it's a question of, well, what do those numbers mean? Well, those numbers, they come back to be a computer program, which is a series of very specific instructions. Still quite a big thing to ask somebody to start with a bunch of switches and ones and zeros and turn those into something which takes two numbers and adds them together, right? That is a difficult question. And so we take the switches and the ones and zeros, and we turn those into things called logic gates, things which do simple human understandable instructions, so anding two numbers together or oring two numbers together. Really, actually quite simple concepts. But the point is that you take the switches and you abstract those into a gate. You take the gate and you abstract that into an instruction like add or subtract or multiply. At the very end of all of this, what we have is a script, a computer program which is human readable, which can execute on the processor and draw a window, draw a button on the screen. We've gone from a switch and a series of ones and zeros, electrons, transistors, quantum mechanics, all the way to having pixels drawn on a screen in, what, 5, 10 steps? And it's simple layers of abstraction, and it allows us to talk about computers at an appropriate level so that we don't have to understand all of the quantum mechanics every time I want to draw a button on the screen, because it would just be unwieldy. I have an iPhone, right? I don't think that's going to be a surprise to anybody. Although, by the way, I much prefer the Windows phone. And I know that my nephews have got smartphones, and I see a lot of kids using games consoles and smartphones. These things don't encourage you to understand what's going on under the hood. I mean, here is a really slick piece of engineering, and it's completely closed. It's a black box. What we've done is we've abstracted the concept of a computer to the point where it's one single black box, and I don't need to understand how any of this works. All I need to know, and this is amazing, I mean, plaudits to Apple for this. All I need to know is that this one button does everything. I press this button and it does everything, which is a remarkable achievement. That is what abstraction can do for you, but it worries me as an engineer and as a scientist that if this is what kids are growing up with, what is it that's encouraging them to ask the question, how does this work? Where's the new generation of engineers and scientists and people who want to take this apart? There's not even a screw I can take out. Where are the people who want to take this apart and see how it works going to come from if there's not a screw that I can take out the back and have a really good fiddle around inside? I remember my acorn electron, it's appeared in other videos. Isn't that satisfying? The biggest, blockiest piece of computer you could possibly imagine. It had a terribly non-ergonomic keyboard. Crucially, it had screws in the back, and I could take them out and I could open it up and I could see how this thing worked, or I could begin to imagine how this thing worked. And that's what fired the imagination of an 11-year-old James. Today, I know it's a really difficult thing to say, how do you take a child and you introduce them to the concept of the ones and the zeros, which are underlying the computer? I am a computerphile, right? I can't wait to do these videos. But we can't talk about anything without first of all defining our terms, right?